So I want to talk today about projections and the miracle of the cucumber. Many years ago in the history of this apparent person, I was staying in an ashram in India, and a very excited and excitable young man was sitting next to me at breakfast, and he told me this story. The guru who ran the ashram took a quite hands-on interest in what went on in the kitchen. And he was also known to sometimes have a quite a remarkably bad temper. And one day he visited the kitchen to watch the devotees at work. And he went up to one who was slicing a cucumber, and he watched him. And when it was finished, the guru said, No, that is not how you do it. You must do it like this. I will show you, and you must get 28 slices from every cucumber. So the guru took the knife, took the cucumber, and went chop, 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 chop. Slice up the cucumber. And the devotees who surrounded him and who were watching him with their usual attitude of awe counted the slices of cucumber. When the job was finished, 24, 25, 26, 27, no more slices. And there must have been a sense of consternation and horror. There was, according to my informant, because it seemed that the guru had made a mistake. And of course, the guru is meant to be infallible. And then the guru turned over the knife. And there, on the other side of the knife, was the 28th slice of cucumber. Relief all round. Maybe the group broke out into spontaneous applause and cheers. I have no idea, but I can imagine that it might happen. So the guru had once again proved to be the infallible fount of wisdom and truth. But the point, in a way, of this story is not the story itself. The point, in a way, of this story is the tone of awe and reverence with which the devotee relayed it to me. I mean, clearly I have referred to this as the miracle of the cucumber with my tongue in my cheek. But in a way, when I think of the reverence with which the devotee told me of this episode, it seems appropriate. It was indeed recounted to me as if this was a minor miracle, one of many that the guru perhaps was capable of bringing about every day. So this is a story about projection. And in a way, it's about the story of the danger of projections. But we cannot help it, in a way. Up to a certain point, we cannot help it that we make projections onto, if we're so inclined, if we have this kind of character, onto gurus and spiritual teachers and holy beings, and perhaps onto sannyasins, and perhaps onto Tibetan lamas. We see them through the eyes of projection. We cannot see them as they actually are, as simply like us human beings. And these projections, of course, bring dangers. One of the dangers may be that when the guru looks at us with deep spiritual liquid eyes and says to us, repeat the mantra after me, open your wallet and help yourself, we may well do that. We may hand over our bank cards, our cash, and maybe in some cases, even our lovers to the guru. This is some of the mischief that projections tend to bring about. Now, it's quite likely that in awakening, it's quite likely that even simply in a split second of awakening, where only the emptiness of everything is seen and not the fullness of everything is seen, it is quite likely that many, or perhaps even all, of our projections may be blown apart, may simply disappear. In some ways, this can seem to the character who's left to be quite sad, because many of us are very fond of our stories of spiritual teachers. Many of us are even addicted to our stories of spiritual teachers. So in some ways, we may regret the passing of these projections, even as 2 or 3 days later, we may be seen going to the nearest charity shop with an enormous box of our spiritual books and guru books to give them away. Yes, in some ways, it can be quite sad and quite a shock to see through our projections. But in another way, it's kind of an inevitable step in a way on the road to freedom, because projections in a way enslave us. And being free of projections is another kind of freedom. So although there is no one who can do anything about this, although, as with everything else, projections simply arise or they do not arise, there may be perhaps some reason to celebrate if we have seen through the miracle of the cucumber.